Hello, hello, and welcome to another Affinity photo tutorial. In this video, we're going to look on how to customize your Affinity photo interface so you have your tools where it's supposed to be, where it's easier. So, first of all, this is how I like to have my Affinity photo interface. Basically, I have one column of tools. Then I have the adjustment panel here, I have the Navigator panel, transform history, library, and on the right hand side I have my layers panel, which is very big, so it can fit a lot of layers. Also, I like to have my color palette here, and at the same time my channels and brushes as well. When I do photo editing, I like to see the histogram and see if the image is balanced or not, and also to have a big workspace area. So let's get started. First of all, I'm gonna reset my studio. So if you go to Window, Studio, Reset Studio. So this is how Affinity looks out of the box. Let's start customizing. First thing that I'm gonna do, and I already have a video on this, but I'm gonna do it quickly here, is I'm gonna update the tools column here. So I'm gonna view, customize tools, and you can delete some tools, so you can not delete, but remove some tools from the toolbar here, and you can add your own tools. What I want to do is to have this blur effect, so I want this camera blur or lens blur. I want to have some depth of field blur. And what I don't use is undo brush tool. I want this pen tool to be here. And to be honest, that's about it. We can leave it as default. If you want to have two columns, click on this, or two or more columns. I want to have as much space as possible to work, so I'm gonna keep it with one column. Click close. And now let's go ahead and click on window. Add the adjustment panel, drag the adjustment panel onto your left until this is highlighted, and just drop it. Let's move the navigator as well. So click on the navigator here, click and hold, and just move it. Sometimes you're gonna see that it's a bit fiddly, so let's say if you want transform, you can see that you need to try to move your mouse until you find the right position. Now, if we are dropping the transform panel here, you're gonna see that it changed. So basically it grouped with the navigator panel as well. So you have two tabs here, which is exactly what I want to do mostly, because I don't use transform that much, but it's useful when you have like different objects inside your image. Another thing is history. I don't want it there, I just want it here. But I want my layers panel to be big, because in the end, when I work in Affinity, in Photoshop as well, I tend to have tens of layers. Another thing, let's take the channels and create a new tab here. Have brushes as well, and also I like the color to have it here. So I want to see the color every time, because I do pick a lot of colors, and channels and brushes. So these three tabs work best. Even channels can be at the end. So you have color, brushes, and channels. Stock, I don't use that much, so I'm gonna take it out. But if you want to grab any other panels, you have them here in Window. And if you're happy with this customization, you go to Window, Studio. So let's save our workspace. Go Add Preset, go here, Preset. And there you go. If you're Window, Studio, you have Studio 1 and 2. Well, you'll have whatever name you've put in. And that's about it. It's a very simple tutorial and a very quick tutorial. If you have any comments or suggestions, please leave them below in the comments section. If you liked this video, hit the like button and consider subscribing to my channel. I'm doing this type of tutorials every week, and from time to time I go and explore the area and take my camera with me, and of course I will take you with me as well. Thank you for watching. Until next time, take care.